Hello, I'm Dr. Michael Sabel, Chief of Surgical Oncology at the University of Michigan. Today, mobile technologies have revolutionized many different areas of our life, but we've been relatively slow to adapt them in the field of healthcare. Even though there are multiple medical apps that are available, most of them are relatively simplistic and go for low-hanging fruit. I believe that mobile technologies can greatly improve the delivery of healthcare and enhance patient-physician communication. And at the University of Michigan, we've been doing just that. We've developed the Cancer Ally suite of mobile technologies to help patients navigate through the complex world of multidisciplinary cancer care. In Breast Cancer Ally, one of our Cancer Ally suite of patient navigation apps, we deliver targeted information, meaning not only is the information written in a way that patients can easily understand it, but also it's designed for the mobile interface. It's delivered in a just-in-time fashion, meaning that we deliver the bulk of the information about surgery at the time point that's relevant to patients, prior to their surgery, and then post-operative instructions immediately after their surgery. We deliver the information on chemotherapy at a time where it's relevant, when patients are making decisions about whether to take chemotherapy, what type of chemotherapy, and then during chemotherapy, we manage those toxicities specific to systemic treatments. All of the information is developed by clinical experts and based on evidence-based recommendations, which is actually not true for a lot of the information that patients come across in other mobile technologies as well as on the internet. It is customized information for the treating physicians. An area of frustration for patients is when information on an app or on the internet seems to run counter to the recommendations that their physicians are telling them. By customizing it to the institution, Cancer Ally makes sure that the information is congruent with what they're hearing from their physicians. It is also interactive and patient-specific. It prompts the patient to communicate back to help guide what information is being delivered based on the type of cancer, where they are in treatment, and what information they need at that time point. We also go above and beyond disease management, trying to encourage patients to do those other activities such as diet, exercise, mental exercise, and other activities that can also enhance their recovery, decrease morbidity, and improve well-being. Here we see some screenshots from Breast Cancer Ally. Even though the educational information is targeted to the patient, patients always have the option of browsing the library and seeing a host of information about breast cancer treatment. They have a calendar that can help remind them of appointments, when to take medications, keep them on track, as well as a host of other resources that can be useful to a cancer patient going through therapy. The app solicits feedback, and the education delivered is based on that feedback. And so we query the patient where they are in the treatment cycle, what have they completed, what decisions are they facing. And based on the information that a patient enters in, we can then deliver to them education, post-operative instructions, and tools specific to where they are in treatment. This is a patient who reported having a modified radical mastectomy. And so they have post-operative instructions and education specific to that operation, as well as being asked to use the drain manager, do the exercises, and other tools specific to that operation. Here are some examples of the exercises. Because this patient had an axillary node dissection, we would encourage them to do these following exercises. We show them how to do the exercises, and we can track whether or not they're doing it. Patients who did not have an axillary node dissection would never see this information since it's not relevant to their case. We also do the same thing during systemic therapy. And here, based on the information that we receive from the patient, we can track the side effects for those regimens. And we can intervene early, reminding patients to call us for serious side effects, getting more information as necessary to help determine whether this is something that needs to be treated emergently or not, and then delivering to the patient specific educational materials for the symptoms that they're having. Here's an example of an education page for a patient who's reported that they've been having diarrhea and how they can manage this without necessarily contacting their healthcare provider. All of this is fed back to the physicians. So when the doctor sees the patient in the office, they have a report of what symptoms the patient has been reported, which not only improves the accuracy of the communication, but lets the doctor follow up on this to make sure that we're delivering the best care possible. All of this information is tracked and can be used to generate a treatment summary that can be shared with other physicians, including primary care physicians and other treating physicians for whom this information would be relevant. We're presently researching the impact of mobile technologies in the Cancer Ally Suite specifically on reducing patient morbidity. For example, we can track whether or not patients are doing exercises after an axillary node dissection or neck dissection and objectively measuring improvements in shoulder or neck dysmotility problems. We can also track what patients are reporting in terms of side effects of chemotherapy and whether or not early intervention is reducing trips to the emergency room, readmissions to the hospital, or calls to the healthcare provider. Breast Cancer Ally is presently being used at the University of Michigan. All new breast cancer patients at the University of Michigan will receive the app as well as instructions how to use it. The feedback is being delivered back to the University of Michigan physicians so they can use the information as they treat the patient. We can also customize this for other institutions that may be interested in using Cancer Ally apps at their home institutions.